Hi there. Bones are one of the strongest organic substances on Earth. Unusable for the bacteria and microorganisms found in the ground, they can survive the test of time for hundreds, sometimes even thousands of years, if the conditions are right. In the oceans, however, one animal found even use for these last remains. Ocedux, the so-called zombie worm, or bone worm, a genus of marine worms that was only discovered relatively recently, in 2002, living in the bones of a whale skeleton on the deep sea floor and slowly eating away at them. Today, we will take a closer look at these bizarre creatures. In the first years after its discovery, the zombie worm raised more questions than answers. Not only was it unclear how they drill into the bones, with no apparent drilling mechanism, but also how they could eat the bones while lacking both a mouth and a stomach. The fact that they managed to spread across most oceans of the world and become surprisingly diverse, all while seemingly exclusively feeding on whale bone, a material that is somewhat limited and rare in our oceans, was also something of a paradox. So in order to unravel some of these mysteries, a team from the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute deliberately sank 5 carcasses of stranded whales into the ocean. This allowed the team to gain first-hand insight into the life cycle and the eating habits of these worms. They begin their lives as microscopic larvae, floating through the deep ocean. If they come across a sufficiently decomposed carcass of an animal, usually a whale, they will settle onto its bones and start growing. Rather than drilling into the bone in a conventional way, Ocedux uses acid to dissolve its way into the skeleton. This acid is produced by root-like tissues on the front end of the worm's body, the part of the worm that penetrates the bone. At the other end, the end that sticks out of the bone, it develops feathery appendages that look a little bit like trees. These so-called palps function like lungs, taking in oxygen from the surrounding water. If you think about it, in a way they are very similar to plants, but they are worms nonetheless. The acid they produce frees fats and oils from the whale's bones, which are then absorbed. With no stomach themselves, they rely on a symbiosis with endothermic bacteria that live inside the roots and digest the fat and the protein for them. The waste products of this process supply the worms with the nutrients they need to survive. But these bacteria aren't the only thing living inside the worms. Sexually mature worms, which are exclusively female, also maintain harems of dwarf males inside their palps that remain in their microscopic larvae stage and act as sperm donors. In contrast to chromosomal sex determination found in mammals, for example, this is likely a form of environmental sex determination. If a larva comes into contact with bone, it develops into a female. If a larva comes into contact with another female, however, it transforms into a dwarf male. Females typically produce hundreds of eggs daily. A large colony of Ocedux, considering of thousands of individuals, can therefore release millions of eggs per day into the ocean, which is essential for the opportunistic exploration of sunken vertebrate bones. After these worms were discovered, researchers began to 3D scan fossilized remains of many different oceanic animals from different time periods to find out when exactly these worms appeared in our oceans. They discovered that they didn't, as originally thought, co-evolve with whales, but must have evolved much earlier, at least 100 million years ago. The unique holes these worms produce could be identified in the fossils of plesiosaur and sea turtle bones from the early to late Cretaceous, suggesting that they started by feeding on the skeletons of large marine reptiles that roamed the ocean in the age of the dinosaurs. When these huge reptiles disappeared from our oceans 66 million years ago, they likely made do with the corpses of sea turtles and marine birds until whales emerged another 20 million years later. This shows that Ocedux is, or at least was, less of a specialist on whale bones than previously thought, and that the ability to colonize the bones of different vertebrate animals is an ancestral trait. But it also means that by destroying bones and skeletons before they became fossils, Ocedux may be responsible for the loss of fossil records of countless marine species over the course of the last 100 million years, or more, leaving holes not just in the bones they ate, but also in our understanding of the evolution of marine life.